Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I want to walk through some Power BI desktop settings that maybe you didn't know about. They're a little bit hidden, and I want to make sure that you're aware of them because they may come up and be useful for you at some point in the future. All right, you know, we like to do it here on Guy in the Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. We are in Power BI Desktop, and if you have on object editing enabled, you will see this little gear icon down on the bottom. This is your shortcut to get to the settings dialog, which is amazing. It reduces the clicks, and I love reduction of clicks. The first thing I want to go to is we're going to go up to data load. One thing to realize here is that the global affects every Power BI desktop file that you have, and then current file just affects that specific file that you're in. Pretty obvious. And if we look at time intelligence, auto date time for new files, this is an item where if you have a date column in your data, it will automatically build a calculated table for you with the hierarchy of a calendar. This will be done for every date column within your model. I did a video a while back called like the one checkbox to fix things, and it was basically disabling this to free up a ton of space. What Patrick and I talk about is creating a central calendar table for your model where you wouldn't need this. This is great if you're just starting with Power BI Desktop, you just want to get up and running. However, as you get a more defined data model and the data is set, you have multiple date columns and you need to actually do some time intelligence that's effective across different elements, that's where you want that calendar table. You should disable this. This setting is there for all Power BI desktop files. If you go to data load under current file, it's also there as well. And you'll notice that it is disabled for this specific file. All right, this next setting is relating to Power Query and it has to do with parameterization. Let's say that like five times fast. If we go over to Power Query Editor under global, you'll see a setting here. It says always allow parameterization in data sources and transformation dialogues. That's cool. What does that mean? So let me go to get data and we'll go to SQL Server. That actually enables this dropdown right here. So you can actually say, I just want a text value, I want a parameter, or I want to define a new parameter. This will also be available as you go through different settings inside of Power Query itself. So if I didn't have that checked, you wouldn't see these dropdowns, you'd just have a text box. This enables a lot of cool scenarios where you can actually parameterize certain things and use those as options when you're selecting items. So for example, the server and database name, I can actually have that defined as a parameter and I can update those parameters once I publish this to the service. So that way, if you want to switch between like a dev database, test database, or production database, you can do that using this parameter. The next item we're going to look at is diagnostic items. So let's go back into options and you'll see an item here called diagnostics. So you can enable tracing. So this has to do a lot with the Power Query tracing, like the mashup tracing that you can do. You can also enable a crash dump. I love dumps. So this will actually dump things out. This is really used for just diagnosing. If you run into issues, you can get more detailed information. You can clear the trace folder. You can also open the folder where this information is going to be. And then you can collect that diagnostic information. And when you do this, it will dump it out into a zip file for you. So if you do end up working with support or you need to go and get more information about what's actually happening, always a handy thing to have available. The next I want to talk about is preview features. I think most of you are aware that this exists, but for those that don't, if you're new to Power BI, I want to let you know about this great secret. It's not a secret. So we're back in the options. You'll see this preview feature item. You can see I just check everything and I love using the latest and greatest. If you just install Power BI Desktop, all of these will be disabled and your experience is a little different. These are preview items that are not generally available. So they're still collecting feedback on these items and looking at telemetry and improving these items. So the Power BI project item, this is a very cool item. If you want to start leveraging like Git and things of that nature, the new card visual. Every month when I install a new version of Power BI Desktop, I go through and I look at these items. Obviously, choose the items that are right for you. And if you're not comfortable using preview items, then don't enable them. But as you look at videos here on Guy in a Cube, at least, we always have these enabled. So you may see certain things that you're like, wait, I don't see that in Power BI Desktop. It's probably because there's a preview feature enabled. This next setting I talked about in a previous video that I did, and I just want to highlight it here as well. So if we go to report settings, this has to do with on object editing, and this will be the always show the build a visual menu in the pane switcher. And now you'll see this build a visual pane is over here instead of it being on the actual visual itself. So it's a way that you can go ahead and determine how you want to use the on object interaction, if you want it on the visual or to the pane switcher. And there's multiple ways to do this too. If you go to view under pane switcher, you can say move this. You also saw I did it in the context menu here. And then it's also a setting in the settings area for report settings. The last one I want to talk about is query reduction. If you're using direct query, this is absolutely something you should pay attention to. Under current file, you're going to see this query reduction area. So one thing you can do is disable the cross highlighting and filtering by default. So this has to do with edit interactions between visuals, and you can customize how those interact. Because by default, when you select on like a bar in a bar chart, it's going to update every visual on the canvas. And if you're using direct query, that's a lot of queries going to hit your data source, and you may not want that. So this is a way that you can reduce the number of queries that are going to your data source and improve performance and also make your DBA happy because you're not hammering their server. There's also this idea of an apply button for the slicers for each individual slicer. And you'll notice this apply all slicers button to each page. That is a great way to do this as well. And then filters also, you can do an apply button on the filter piece in addition to that. But it gets even better for direct query. If you go to the optimize side, you can do this apply all slicers button, which is great. So that does everything on the canvas and that's recommended. And then you can also do some other items here to get a better experience. And you can pause visuals, refresh visuals. When you're in direct query mode, this is a great thing to go look at. Just a couple of quick tips. Hopefully you were aware of all those. If not, maybe you learned something. Let me know in the comments if you discovered something that you weren't aware of, or if there's something else you want to share with everyone else. Keep that conversation going. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.